but that's where I live. Consider motherfucking live. I been Steph Curry with the shot, been cooking with the sauce, Chef Curry with the pot, boy. 360 with the wrist, boy. What's going on, YouTube? Ollie Dope checking in once again. Happy New Year. Welcome to 2020. First tutorial of the year. Steph Curry with the pot. Missed the 62 points. Let's get straight into it. First, you know, I just gotta set my photos up, cut my photos out. Right now, I'm just going through my photos and placing them and stuff like that. Now, this is a new technique. All you have to do is click on the magic wand tool and click on select subject. You could select the sky and all that. I think it's a new update for Adobe CC 2021. So this, I'm just playing with my levels a little bit. I'm getting a little bit darker, getting his hair a little bit black, stuff like that. Cut out some more photos, placing my objects. I'm just setting up my main image for my main composition. Once again, all you gotta do is select subject and then inverse, and there you go. Add a little feather on there if you're being fancy. All right, so like I'm gonna start adding a little bit of extra elements now. So I'm just adding the Spalding because this is a basketball design. So putting that in the back, I want it a little bit darker as well. So I'm gonna play with the levels. So it matches the overall feeling of the. Now here I'm just adding some shapes just to give it that, you know, abstract wallpapery feel. I feel like they always have like random shapes and random like lines and stuff in their photos, so that's why I was inspired by. And I'm just adding like a simple gradient overlay to it that's gonna complement the background. And the background is just like a nice like dark gray. I didn't even do black. I feel like I use black for a lot of my bases. And you can adjust the shape here by just clicking on the direct selection tool and clicking on the path. Yep, and then just move it to the shape that you feel like. You can play with this with stars, triangles, circles, all that. Shape here so we can give some depth to the background. As you can see, it looks like it's like coming together like already. It's all about complementary colors, complementary shapes, stuff like that. I actually don't end up keeping this picture of Steph in the back, but you just play with different photos and different placements to feel what you feel is right. I added a brick element on there just to give it some contrast once again. Added a picture of him shooting that three, right? And who is that? Fred Van Fleet's face? Splash! Once again, just play with the blending modes. Move it over a bit so they can see a little bit better. There we go. See, I end up just deleting that. I'm trying to get the right blending mode for the background for this like extra shape because it's a little bit too dark on the bottom image. I add another image of him, you know, supporting his other friends making threes. And I'd use black and white for all these as well. And then I play with the blending mode. And to get this separation, I just added two images of the same one and did different type of blending modes, and then just deleted the other side. All right, so now I'm adding a picture. I think this is the Golden Gate Bridge, if I'm correct. All my Bay people, you know what I'm saying? Shout your city out. Shout out Oakland. Once again, black and white everything. Play with the settings. And now I'm adding a gradient map to the basketball to give it that blue to contrast the yellow. Y'all see what I'm doing here? Yes, sir. Now you add the, go into your layer styles, and you're just gonna add like a simple outer glow, and I'm gonna add an inner glow as well of a lighter blue, just so it can give it that glowy inside and out feel. Okay. The layer. Now I just duplicated that gray shape, that gray rectangle I had, and made it blue, and then just made it smaller to go on the other side. Once again, just for, you know, complementary shape purposes, squares and circles for this one. Now this one, like I said, adding just some more liney elements for, because it's supposed to be a wallpaper. I just used some line type font or line type brush that you guys can find like online. Oh yeah, my pack is coming out in February or March. Trying to just solidify the date, but yeah, be on the lookout for that. And it's a big pack too. Is gonna be having markers, stuff to use for videos, not only just photos as well. So that should be really dope. Cool, now I just use, what font is this? I think it's Dirk Wide. And I just used the old English in the back and adjusted the overlay, the blending mode. Nothing too crazy. Once again, adding a little gradient with a little drop shadow on the 30. Add a little Golden State just so it feels more like official. The right feeling on there. Okay, now you're gonna add a little motion blur to this one. Motion, Gaussian, whatever was gonna work for you. I just want to give it more of a rustic type of look for the text because it's sitting on top of that old English font. All I did here is just duplicated a few times just because I think it's cool and it's complementary to the right side. It's a lot going over there, so let's try to make a little bit of something going on the left side. And I just, once again, just playing with the blending modes. Cool, so now we're just going to select the curry one, select that one by itself, and then go ahead and play with that blending mode, so then you can just have just a Steph Curry. Because all these, I actually grouped them together and made them smart objects, so the background was always with the forefront, which would be the Steph Curry part. Cool, that looks good right there. So let's go ahead and adjust the blending modes of this blue a little bit. Only because I feel like if it's on the blue, it should be able to stand out a little bit more than that. So let's play with the blending modes. And everything is trial and error. Like, everybody was like, oh, which one exactly? Like, you just got to see what works for the colors and the scheme that you're trying to do. I kind of see when I like, that kind of sees the water, all that good stuff. Cool. Bet. All right, so let's add some Splash. You know, he's part of one half of the Splash Brothers, you know. Get well, Clay, you know what I'm saying? So we got to add some Splash in there because he did just drop 62. He was splashing on them fools for show. We're going to duplicate that and then we're going to flip it so it's on the other side of the basketball as well. So it looks like it's like being submerged in water or something. And I think I'm going to add some more water at the bottom as well just to give it that fully splash like main image feeling. Yeah, we're going to do one on that side and then we're going to duplicate it, flip it, and put it on the other side as well. One more little image up there of him shooting. Nothing too crazy. Just play with the blending modes, make it black and white, just like everything else. Add one more image. I just felt like, I don't know, why not? Same thing, cut it out, make it black and white. I'm just gonna play with the placement a little bit, see where I wanna put it. I think we'll put it right behind him. So it's like going into the Steph, going into the city type thing. Final touches, go ahead and add some good scratches and just go ahead and screen that or lighten it. There we go, now it's starting to come together. We're gonna add that right over there over the text to give the text its own individual like feeling. I actually end up changing the main image background. I didn't like him in that damn shirt, so yeah, did him with his famous mouth guard movement. So yeah, we're just gonna add that one more time. Sometimes last minute changes is perfectly fine with me, man. Whatever makes it look the best. All right, well, don't forget to like, comment, share, and until next time, you guys, keep creating, stay creative, stay safe, and have a happy new year.